Hello, and welcome. I'm Zinder, and this is the level 35 ninja quest. I will learn the mudra chi, the hand gesture for earth, from this apparently, and 4,500 experience. Katarina, why I did not even hear your footsteps as you approached. You are becoming more and more the shinobi with each day. Aboro has been waiting your return. Please enter. Oh, now you're just going to say you may enter. You're not even going to ask me the question anymore. It's because you don't expect me to remember the password, isn't it, Gabe? Katarina, it is clear from the manner in which you carry yourself that you have been most diligent in your training. But you are not the only one who has mastered the technique imparted to you. Behold, my Eorzean bow, perfect in balance and form. Ahem. Now it is time for your next lesson. Watch carefully my hands, Katarina. With this mudra, the shinobi can summon the energies of the earth, chi in our tongue. Etch its form in your mind, and I shall show you how to employ it in battle. Okay, so this gives me the ability. Chi. And now I pick up the next quest from him. Aboro would impart a new mudra to his promising pupil. Chi, or Earth, marks the second mudra that you have learned. With this, you are ready to begin the next phase of your training. It is through the combination of mudra that you will find new techniques. The first technique I would impart to you is Raiton, lightning release. When the heavens join with earth, lightning will flash and thunder will roll. In other words, form the mudra 10 followed by chi. Channel that energy forward and bolts of lightning will surge from your hands to strike your foe. As this is a more formidable technique than the Fuma Shuriken you have wielded thus far, I have taken care to reinforce the Mukujin outside the storehouse. Strike it with Raitan, and I shall observe. Okay, so, as you can tell, I've relocated my bars. These buttons here, they are bound to shift 1, shift 2, shift 3, and shift 4. These are PvP abilities, but I haven't done any PvP yet. Okay, exit the storehouse. So, for reference's sake, let's have a look at... Katan? Ooh. Delivers fire damage with a potency of 180 to target and all enemies near it. Delivers lightning damage with a potency of 360. Holy crap! Okay. Shift 1, shift 2, Q. Very well. Now recall what I said during our first lesson. The techniques at your disposal are created not merely by which mudra you form, but also the order in which you combine them. When earth joins with heaven, the skies will rain fire and ash. In other words, form the mudra chi, followed by 10, and channel those energies forward, and searing hell's fire will engulf your foes. But be forewarned, these techniques require considerable exertion of your spirit. After performing one, you will observe that some time is required before your mind settles, and you are able to wield another. Now demonstrate Katan for me on the Mokujin over there. Wait. The recast timer is the same. Okay. So now he wants me to chi 10. I have decreased graphics on because these things would be absolutely excessive if I had the full spell effects on, so, meh. Plus, I'm not sure if it's working very well on the dummy. Splendid! Your grasp on fundamental mudra combinations is firm, but knowing how of the technique is only the beginning. You must also understand when to employ it. Chunin is our word for a shinobi who has attained full mastery of two mudra techniques. In our tradition, when a student is deemed by his master to show such potential, she is led to a waterfall outside the village to conduct intense training. I cannot take you to Doma, of course, but my maps tell me of a place in Upper Linoshka that should suffice. Fool Falls. That name is less than auspicious, but it will have to do. Meet me there, and we shall proceed. So, he wants me the whole way over there. Okay, that is a pretty obscure location. But we have been through this path before. Bum-ba-dum. I was actually worried that this video is going to be ridiculously short, but I actually muted Steam and whatnot this time because I was receiving messages on Steam asking me questions. So, yeah. We're not gonna have 1,000 Steam message noises. So, up there, there is, I believe, corals? Curls, or basically cats. There's cats. I'm not entirely sure what the exact pronunciation is, but that has never stopped me from pronouncing things wrong in the past. But anyhow, nope, stuck in a rock. Now I'm trying to walk out into water that I cannot walk into. Mostly because I'm not paying attention to where I'm going. Partly because I don't really care. So, this should get us to that which we seek. So I'm assuming he's going to have me fight him as a practice for the techniques. Chi 10 for AoE and 10 Chi for single target. I'm assuming that they plan to teach me is that. Until today, I knew this place was only I knew this place only as letters on a map. Gazing upon it with my own eyes, it is even more beautiful and powerful than I could have imagined. Yet this, yes, this will serve us well. My people do not worship your deities, 12. Our gods are all around us, in the trees, in the soil, in the crashing waters before you. Close your eyes and open your heart to the sound of the rushing falls, that you might purge your mind of all worldly thoughts and distractions. The techniques you have learned will serve you well in battle, but confuse the order of your mudra, and you can just as easily turn victory into defeat. It is imperative that you keep a single focus of mind. So it is that the masters have brought their students to falls like this one for training since my ancestors' times. Who is the more foolish? The fool of the fool falls, or the fool who comes here without realizing he's been followed? This idiot. Karasu! Now here's a curious scene. The dim one is accompanied today not by his swallow, but by a chirping horsebird chick who fancies herself a shinobi. The dim one is pleased. This after our hero postponed two assassinations to make this little journey. Could his friends not greet him with a smile and some crumpets, or whatever it is the Orizians like to take with their tea? The dim one ponders, how did our hero know to find him here? Yet the answer is plain as day. The dim one is a creature of habit and tradition. Where else would he bring his prized new pupil? Tradition! Our hero spits on the tired tradition. No, for he is a shinobi of a different feather, ever changing, never predictable, but always, always in style. Those who cling too close to tradition are bound to suffer the fate of their forebears, or are the lessons of the past so soon forgotten? Ready yourself, Katarina. It appears that your training today will be more of a more practical sort. But of course, all you had to do was ask nicely. It would be my pleasure to be your teacher for the day. Your first lesson, little chick Raiton's lightning will strike a single foe, while Katon's flames will raise many. Wield them wisely, or don't. It's only your life at stake. Oh, how generous is our hero, putting aside his killings and spyings to play mother hen to the horsebird chick. You will try to keep me entertained then, won't you? So. Well, I fucked that up. And that's what happens when you screw up a mudra. I was here, there, but now I'm here. Can you not see? Must they be so slow? Our hero tires of this dull dance. If you're going to kill me, could you be a bit quicker about it? Okay, that's a horrible thing. I figured it was a horrible thing, but... Alas, I fear a teacher has better places to be. But worry not, my pawns will continue the lesson. Kurosu, come back and face me with honor! G10Q. He's going to heal me, as is expected. Oh, come on. So, things are being a bit difficult. That's not the game's fault. That's my fault. If you remember, I said I was going to basically put the videos up as I get them done. Well, I'm uploading videos right now. The previous ones, as a matter of fact. Killed with Raitan. The cool thing I noticed about the Mudras is they're not attached to the global. He's going to attack me, isn't it? What I mean by that is whenever I cast them, you can see it doesn't set the other abilities on that, the global right there. Which means that you cast them while the other abilities are preparing. So, that's always fun. You fought well, Katarina. I, however, should have known to expect the traitor's attack. I was careless and put you in danger. It will not happen again. It appears that Kurosu has taken an interest in you, and I fear this complicates matters some. Let us return to the docks. There is much I would tell you. Bum bum bum! So, after this, there's going to be three more sets of quests. Although I can't be sure how quickly I'm going to get them out, I'm going to try and hit 50 in the next couple days. But that, well, that's not necessarily as assured as it is, because queue times are excessive because of the number of people currently rolling as DPS. New classes are always fun. Let me in, please. Thank you very much. Okay, what say you? I would tell you a story of our past. A story of the traitor and why he must die at our hands. Growing up in the same village, I have known Kurosu since we were both children. When we came of age, we began our training together under Master Gekai. From a young age, it was clear that Kurosu possessed an innate talent for our art that few could rival. I spared no effort in my training, yet struggled to grasp techniques that he would master effortlessly. In his own way, he possesses a mind singularly devoid of wasteful thoughts, a mind seemingly unclouded by concepts such as right or wrong, good or evil. Despite this, deep down, I always thought of him as a brother. All that changed on that fateful day when the Garleans shattered Doma's defenses. Someone had betrayed our homeland, sold our secrets to the enemy. Looking upon my friends as their bodies lay broken and bleeding, I saw a figure flee into the hills. It was Karasu. Were I younger, more naive, I might have pursued Karasu as he fled in an attempt to reason with him. But it was clear that this man, this demon, was no longer one of us, if indeed he ever had been. Even Master Gekai did not survive the slaughter. Did Karasu bear him some grudge, or is it merely a student's ugly pride? For our master's fate was the grisliest of all, his body mangled, his once proud face shattered beyond all recognition. I once held out hope, hope that if I crossed blades with Karasu in battle, that I might understand something of what it was that made him do those horrible deeds. Yet each encounter only raises more questions. One thing is clear, however. Karasu could have killed us back at Fool Falls had he seen fit, and yet chose not to, as if he were testing us, testing you. Needless to say, this does not change our mission. For his crimes against Doma, Karasu must pay with his life, and yet his thorough knowledge of us and our art has put Tsubame and I at a grave disadvantage. But you, Katarina, your thoughts, your movements are still unfamiliar to him. Yes, your presence might just serve to break his focus and afford us an opening. Yet to accomplish this, you must become stronger still. Promise me that you will not let up in your training. Why would I let up in my training? Ooh. A preview of what's to come at level 40! So. That'll be fun. Can't wait. But I'm gonna call this good for now, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good day!